people, you learn about your city, but the most important thing, the most valuable thing I got from it is the friendships. You meet people who will be lifelong friends that you can call after not seeing them for a year, and you just pick up where you left off. So anyone who's considering leadership Plano, I strongly urge you to try to get in, because it is an incredible experience. Leadership Plano's mission is to identify, educate, and develop future leaders for the Plano community, and to motivate these potential leaders for civic, charitable, and community involvement. Tonight, we will recognize a true example of this mission, as well as those leaders who have helped make this program one of Plano's shining stars. Leadership Plano, of course, is a program of the Plano Chamber of Commerce. The Chamber leadership provides outstanding support, and I'd like to recognize Jamie Jolly, CEO of the Chamber, to stand and receive our appreciation. We want to thank Downs Fisher Financial Services for sponsoring this evening. It serves two major purposes in addition to reconnecting with old friends and meeting new ones. First, we're here to recognize Missy Bender as the recipient of the 2018 Distinguished Leadership Award, and to acknowledge and honor her commitment as an exemplary leader and public servant in Plano and beyond. The second purpose is to invite interested candidates and future leaders to consider applying for Leadership Plano Class 36. Best class ever. We hope you've taken the opportunity to meet and visit with Leadership Plano alumni and board members to learn more about the program and its valued curriculum. We will now begin with the presentation of the Distinguished Leadership Award. This award is presented by the Association of Leadership Programs and is designed to recognize exceptional community leadership program graduates. Recipients are men and women who have made significant and notable contributions to the betterment of their communities and who exemplify the spirit and goals for civic involvement and trusteeship. Each year, our recipients exceed our expectations of leadership. I now invite to the stage Beth Webb, a graduate of Leadership Plano Class 14, valued civic volunteer, and Plano Chamber's Citizen of the Year, to introduce our award recipient and guest of honor. Beth will be joined by Leadership Plano Board Chair Suzanne Drotman in the presentation. Welcome, Beth.
Good evening. I am thrilled to have the opportunity to visit with you about my wonderful friend, Missy Bender. The challenge for me tonight is that Missy is so involved in our community, it'll be impossible to mention everything she's done. I'll try to give you a little history, highlight a few fun facts, fill you in on areas of our community that Missy has impacted, and hopefully when I'm done, you'll know a little more about this amazing lady. Missy was born in Joplin, Missouri, to her very young parents, Tommy and Carolyn. In 1975, they moved to Plano, and Missy later became part of the first class to attend Plano East Senior High. And yes, she was a class officer. This smart, determined high school graduate earned several scholarships to SMU. She was a four-year university scholar and received a BBA degree in marketing. The summer between high school and college, Missy met Doug on a blind date. She was an incoming freshman and he was a senior. They had a three-year-long distance relationship and married May 9th, 1987, the day after her last final. Doug, I know you don't need this reminder, but here it is. Tomorrow's your anniversary. Got it covered. Extra large in diamonds and jewelry. Those of you that have had the pleasure of working with Missy know she's a strategic thinker. It is no surprise she excelled in her career as a management consultant, specializing in strategic planning and technology solutions. So successful, in fact, that while working at IBM, she was honored with the recognition as one of the company's elite top 1% performers. Over the next 10 years, she and Doug moved all over North America, and in 1999, they decided to move back home to Plano, raise a family here, and be active members of our community. They had their beautiful daughter, Maddie, who is finishing her freshman year at SMU right now, and Missy started volunteering. She joined the Junior League, the Plano Metro Rotary Club, her Homeowners Association, and the Daffron Elementary PTA. And again, it was no surprise, she ended up in leadership roles in all of these organizations. In 2006, when Maddie was in the first grade, Missy successfully ran for Plano ISD Board of Trustees, and she currently is serving her fourth term. Over the past 12 years, she's been on the board. She has been elected by her fellow trustees to serve as board vice president, board secretary, and last night, she was elected to serve her third year as president. In the area of education, she has also been on the boards of Robinson Middle School, PTA, Jasper High School, Booster Club, Plano West Choir Booster Club, Plano Alumni Association, and the Plano ISD Education Foundation. She was appointed by TASB, and those of you that don't know these acronyms, that's the Texas Association of School Boards, to the TEA, which is the Texas Education Agency. As the only trustee on the state's Accountability Policy Advisory Committee, and she is also on the TEA School Finance Council, Missy has earned the prestigious designation Master Trustee. She is a fellow with the Center of Reform of School Systems. She received TASB's 2014 Outstanding Leadership Award, and she has been honored as a PTA Life member. She has served on in the TASB Legislative Advocacy Committee and often testifies before the House and Senate Education Committees on behalf of Plano ISD and all Texas school districts. She is a frequent presenter also at state and national school board conferences and has worked with other trustees in the North Texas Region Consortium to develop a regional legislative agenda. Over the years, I've seen firsthand this incredible work ethic, dedication, and commitment she has provided for the quality education for all children. Our local campuses, district boards, PTAs, alumni group, state and federal school board associations have all benefited from Missy's advocacy and passion for education. Now, let me just list off a few other fun facts about Missy. She's a graduate of Leadership Plano, Leadership St. Andrew, Leadership TASB, and Leadership Texas. She was named one of 21 leaders for the 21st century by Inside Collin County Business. She received the Woman in Politics Award by the League of Women Voters, and she was named as a Girl Boss 2017 by Plano Magazine. And now, you might wonder if it's even possible for Missy to have served in other areas of the community. Yes, indeed. It is, and she has. And here are just a few more. The Chairman's Council for Texas Health Resources Plano, Women Making a Difference, Connor Harrington Republican Women, National Charity League, and Plano Symphony Debutante Program. Whether it is as a committee member, a general volunteer, or a leadership role, Missy is always willing to serve to better an organization and help it meet its goals. I bet you have noticed there is no job too big or too small for Missy. I've seen her help in a classroom, update spreadsheets late into the night, drive a beer cart at a golf tournament, research and implement the first digital platform for the Junior League while running for school board. I've seen her serve ice cream, and I've seen her mentor young mothers. She is one classy lady, and you can count on her to give it her all. Some words that describe Missy: insightful, innovative, thoughtful, strategic, detailed, future-focused, tenacious, respected, efficient, goal-oriented, eloquent, trusted, strong character, good listener, a truth seeker, a graceful, calming force, a visionary, an advocate, a servant leader, and a friend. We are so fortunate Missy and Doug strategically decided to come back home, back to Plano. I am so happy the Leadership Plano program is recognizing Missy tonight, celebrating her exceptional involvement, significant impact, and long-term commitment to our community. Her devotion is to be applauded. So, if you would, please join me and Suzanne Drotman as we recognize and honor the 2018 Distinguished Leadership Award recipient, our friend, Missy Bender.
It's kind of like being at your wedding reception where your smile is just pasted to your face and you're seeing all your friends and your family. At the same time, you feel like you're at your funeral where people are saying the nice things about you, but you get to hear it. Thank you, Beth, for your very beautiful message and for your ever-present, ever-positive support of me and of everything that I want to do. I want to thank Leadership Plano for this award and for Downs Fisher for its sponsorship of this event and the selection committee for honoring me with this award. I have to thank so many, it's like I know all of you here. And all of you have had such an important, you've had some kind of impact on me, but I want to start with my family first. And maybe you can see them, I can't, but some of my family is here, not all of them could be here. My mom, unfortunately, like David, was out of town right now, so my friend Michelle is filming this for me. Unfortunately, my dad has passed, otherwise he'd be here. My husband Doug, my daughter Mandy, my brother Jeremy, stand up so people know who you are. My brother Jeremy, my nephew Luke, my niece Riley, my brother-in-law David, my sister-in-law Martha, and their son Bradley, my stepsister Lisa, her husband John, and their daughter Amanda. I have other family, but those are the ones that are here. Thank you for being here. Now, to my lovely husband and daughter, you've taken this journey with me, and it always hasn't been an easy one to take, but it's one that you've always supported me on. Doug has never, ever done anything other than support me in anything that I ever wanted to do. And that's just kind of how we roll in our marriage. I support him, and he supports me. And, and Maddie has been with me. Maddie, everybody knows you here. Because she's grown up, we've kind of grown up together in the community. And I know, honey, it's been hard at times where mommy hasn't always been home. And I know it was hard, but thank you for still supporting me. And I love you two very much. I also believe, as I mentioned before, that each of you here that I know has had some positive impact you've all played a role in me receiving this award. And what I mean is the support that you've given me, that my current colleagues on the board, my former colleagues, people that I've worked with in my neighborhood, my community groups, my church. Anytime you support someone, you're making a difference. to help them keep on going. So for me, you have a role in this as well. I'm grateful to Leadership Plano for providing the opportunity for me to learn about my community in a very special, unique way. And I'm grateful for the friendships that I made in my class and other classes, and even some of my classmates are here this evening. In fact, Carol Graysdorf was the program director of my class, 23, which is very special. I also want to express gratitude for the Chamber of Commerce, because the Chamber, the board, and Jamie have always been so supportive, not just of me, but also of the school district and the things that we ask them to partner on, they're always there, and that's so critical. Let me share with you a little bit about my journey. Sometimes we wonder if we can have it all. Work, career, family, and friends. And for me, just me, I discovered that I can have it all, but just not all at the same time. And at a recent Bush Institute event, Raja Deepa and Doug and Maddie and Logan, her boyfriend, and I went to hear Jeff Bezos, the Amazon CEO. And he put this in perspective for me. He said, you can have a job, you can have a career, you can have a calling. I had jobs in high school, I had a career in consulting, but I left my consulting career when I had my daughter because I was ready for the next chapter. I was looking for my calling. I mean, I was looking hard. But luckily it found me. So let me tell you a little bit about how it found me and how I find myself here with you and thanking you for your support. Beth mentioned that my parents were really young when they had me. Mom was 16 and in high school, and Dad was 18 in high school. And she found herself pregnant with me. And so my parents got married, and Mom stayed out of school for a little while, and then she came back and finished her high school. You know, there wasn't any support back then for girls like her. My dad cooked French fries at McDonald's, and then he, you know, became a machinist, and T.I. came to town, and they were looking for machinists. In about 1975, and my dad got the job, and we came down here. And I feel like when we came to Plano is when my whole world opened up for me. I started at Foreman Elementary, and, you know, I never really, we didn't talk about college. Nobody in my family had really gone to college. But as I grew through my educational experience in Plano ISD, I began to have teachers who would help me dream big. And by the time I went to a college night at Plano East and I saw SMU there, I'm like, that's exactly where I want to go to school. That's the kind of education I want. So I was going to school half a day and I was working half a day because I kind of needed to do that. So my parents, to their credit, now granted they were young and my mom would kind of probably tell you she didn't know what she was doing. She was trying to figure it all out, kind of like the rest of us. But they never discouraged me. You know, they didn't have any money, they didn't have any money saved, but they didn't say, oh, don't try for that. They just knew where I had a will, there was going to be a way. So I was successful and got scholarships and loans and grants and went to SMU. I got there my freshman year, and I was 17 and my mom was like 32 at that time. And my dad got cancer for the first time then. And my brother Sean and my brother Jeremy were at home. And my mom said, well, I guess I better get my education. So she worked full time. She raised my brothers. And she went to Richland and Collin College. She got her associate's degree. And then she got scholarships. And she went to SMU after me. She graduated 2 years after I did. I'm obviously very, very proud of my mother. she's very humble and you know, doesn't see anything special in all that she did. But all these things in life happen for a reason, I think. And, you know, I went on and had my career, as Beth talked about, when it was time. I was just really focused on having a career. I wanted to make it. I wanted to be successful. I didn't want to have to worry what was in my bank account. But by the time, you know, I had won this nice award at IBM, I told Doug, I think I'm going to do a Michael Jordan. I think I want to go out on top on my terms. I think I'm going to stop working, and I'm going to stay home, and I'm going to raise my daughter, our daughter. So he's like, really? You're sure you want to stop working? So we came home to Plano. Everything had changed. I just had this yearning. I was supposed to do something, and I just didn't know what it was. And it found me when Maddie's in kindergarten, and I'm, you know, volunteering, and I'm listening to the classroom instruction, and I'm looking at the kids, and I'm thinking, you know, a lot of these kids, I think, have maybe very similar stories to me, kind of growing up without much. I think that I want to help these kids in her school, but you know what, I think I want to help all kids in Plano ISD. So that's when I decided to haphazardly run for the school board in that moment. And I called my old high school counselor, Nancy Boyd, who told me, I'm so proud of you, Missy. Now, do your homework. So like a good management consultant, I did my homework for the next year and a half and did a whole SWOT analysis and so forth. And I had to, you know, express gratitude to our mayor, Harry, who was I met at the time at my dad's house at a Christmas party. He had just gotten elected, and he said, I'll help you. So he started introducing me to people in the community. He'd knock on the door, and he'd let, you know, I'd walk in, and then it was up to me after that. So I'm very grateful for that opening that he gave me. I did run for the board, and it was an incredible learning process, and the support. You know, when you're doing something like that, it is super hard. And the people who believe in you, many of you here in this room tonight that have believed in me, I will never, ever forget that. And that's what keeps people like me going, is just you have a dream to help others, and you're passionate about it, and other people get on the train with you. And they're like, I want to help you. I want to lift you up. I had people pushing me. I had people standing beside me. I had people pulling me. And I'm just so grateful for all of that. All of that brings me to this idea of a calling. And your calling could be to lead something, it could be to support something, because both are just equally important. And so many of you in this room have taken this journey with me, and I thank you for being there. You never know when it's your time. You may be just listening to that small voice in your head right now thinking, well, why me? And I would say to you, why not you? Why not you? I think that maybe you should consider that journey through Leadership Plano like I did, where you make great friends, you learn so much about your community, you can discover the thing that you're passionate about. It could be supporting someone whose cause you believe in. It could be leading that cause yourself. And I'm just so very grateful to have had the opportunity to serve my community, because it's really one of the greatest gifts that I've ever received. It's humbling to have you here supporting me tonight, and it's so, it's just so very special. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
Exceptional service to our local and regional community.